Hello and welcome back to Rolling Solo. My name is Adam Smith and today we're going to be looking at an unboxing video for Conan. And as you can see, there is two boxes that are barely fitting into the picture, which is kind of crazy. And the first box here, which is the first one you can see, is the main game box that if you were to go to retail and purchase it, this is the box you'd actually get. And honestly, the amount of content in this box is huge. You don't really need to have this box over here. And what that box is from the Kickstarter exclusives. This game was released last year, and it kind of turned near the tail end of the year, and I actually didn't get my hands on it until now. This is not, and it's going to be a little bit different than what I'm used to, kind of with my Arcadia Quest Inferno unboxing that I did. This channel really focuses on solo gaming, so you might be wondering, well, why the heck are you unboxing a game that isn't solo based? Because this one isn't. You actually do need at least two people in order to play it. However, there is a community behind this game, and solo variants are being created for this game, and it might be something that might come to fruition at some point. And if it does, then I will likely play this game as a playthrough or a gameplay video for you guys, so you can see kind of how you could play this game in a solo situation. Now, just so you get some quick overview of the game in general, the game is actually made by Monolith. They have the rights to Conan, apparently, because otherwise they wouldn't be able to do this. But it's very, very cool. Like, if you look at the artwork on the box, it's very, very, very nice. And I'll actually, it's pretty heavy, so I won't lift it right now. But essentially, the artwork's incredible, just on the outside of the box alone. And I can tell you, for like what I've seen of what's inside the box, it's even better. It's mind-blowing. And Adrian Smith and Georges, looks like they've done an incredible job on the artistry of the game, and they're both well known, especially Adrian. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take the box here in the back, which is the Kickstarter exclusive box. I'm going to throw that off the table for now, because really what I think deserves the most attention, at least straight off the bat, is what you'd get in the retail box if you were to pick it up in a store. Now, essentially, this game, I believe in the store, Canadian anyway, is a little over $100, so about $115. So US, it's probably in the $75 to $80 range. Again, I'm sure you can get it cheaper, or maybe it comes more expensive depending on where you're picking it up. But I can tell you, for the amount of content you're getting in this game, for the price you pay, it is worth it. The game is based in a overlord versus many kind of situation, or one versus many, as some people call it. So essentially, you can have, from what I understand, a large amount of players playing it. The side of the box here actually goes ahead and lets you know that there's 2 to 5. So this is, again, going back to the point that it isn't solo to the box. So don't buy this if you're, you know, expecting there to be a solo, official solo component to this game, because there isn't. Maybe in the future there'll be something that creates that, or someone in the community on Board Game Geek will be able to do that. And I think there's people that have actually created some small scenario specific solo content, but I haven't dived into it myself, so I can't speak to it very well yet. But I can tell you 100% that if they do, or if it is there and I just haven't seen it yet, I will definitely play it through, because I really want to try it out. And I also want to learn the rules too. So let's get back to the unboxing itself, because that's what you guys are here for, and I hope you haven't ran away already with my yammering. So anyway, we got the Conan box here. Again, the artwork is fantastic. I'm going to kind of bring the box up for you guys. You can see, like, it's incredible. Like, the artwork in this game is insane, and the boards actually inside are going to be even crazier, and you'll see in a second. So you go ahead and essentially take the lid off this monster, and you've got what appears to be a large amount of books and stuff. So what you first get off the top is a large pile of individual players. So these are going to be your heroes. So the heroes, you got things like, sorry, let me try to get this thing off. I don't really want to tear it, so I'm going to be trying to be gentle. Yeah, I don't know if it's possible. There we go. So essentially we've got like Conan, for instance, obviously the hero of the box, the coolest character you can be. You got Belit, and she's got some pretty crazy abilities and some crazy artwork as well. Shivatis, Very much a stealth character. I believe movement is a big key of his abilities, unlocking chests and that type of thing, getting around the map. Magic user, so somebody who focuses on conjuring up things and is strong in, on the magic side of situations. So if you buy the core box, you're getting those four characters, and those are really your four. And again, the game plays up 2 to 5. So if you're playing with 5 people, you've got 4 people controlling these heroes, and one person is what is called the Overlord. And the Overlord is going to be controlling all the monsters and minions in the game against the heroes to try to kill them, whereas the heroes are obviously trying to complete the objectives which have been shown, thrown around the scenario, and they're all varied depending on which scenario you're playing. You've also got yourself like a round tracker. So again, as the rounds tick by, certain scenarios will tell you that you've only got so many rounds. And I'm assuming if you get to 15 on some of them, it's over. But also I'm sure that there's some variation in terms of how many rounds happen. These, I believe, are just straight reference cards. So if you're not sure about some of these like abilities here, which are shown kind of like in the green, yellow, and red area here on the player board, then these are just quick references to those skills so that you don't get lost when you're playing the game. So, seems pretty cool. I kind of like what I'm seeing so far. So, put those to the side for a second. So, the next thing you're going to get is the Conan Overlord book. So, this is going to be for the individual who's playing as the leader of the enemies or enemy forces in this game, and forgive me for not understanding Conan's backstory as well as I probably should. There are movies I've seen them, but I still don't know the terminology to everything Conan, so forgive my ignorance in that knowledge area. But you've got the Overlord book. This is going to tell you everything you need to know in order to figure out how to play the Overlord. He's got a really cool kind of tray here that the Overlord uses and purchases enemies in a certain manner using gems. And this track here moves, and when you pay 1 for 7, it moves to the bottom, or sorry, moves to the very end, becomes more expensive the next time you use it, and then the rest shuffle down. It's very, very cool mechanics. So the rule book, I can't make too many comments on it, and maybe if I do a component review video, I'll talk about the rule book and stuff like that once I get to learning it, to let you guys know if I think it's even a decent rule book in the first place. But in terms of picture quality and artistry and stuff, It's pretty cool. So then again, you've got like Conan the Hero book, and this book's actually pretty cool. So you get like a whole bunch of scenarios, and you got yourself like everything you need to know about the heroes. So again, straightforward, glossy pages, nice artwork, everything looks good there. Okay, so the next thing you get in the regular retail box is dice. So from what I understand, without playing this yet, is the yellow is the weakest dice and typically is used with armor. Orange, it's kind of midway in terms of like it has a little bit better chance of success on the orange dice. And red is your best. So in terms of best weapons, strongest retaliation, that type of thing, usually the red is what you're looking for dice-wise. And the player boards let you know kind of what you're supposed to roll, actually. So if I was to go ahead and grab one of the player boards, like this magic user, for instance, if you're going to go ahead and do an attack move, then you roll a yellow dice. If you're going to do a ranged move, I believe, yellow dice. If you're going to defend, you're using an orange dice, things like that. So it kind of gives you a heads up as to how much movement you can do and your limits on how many gems you can add to it to boost it and all that kind of stuff. If you're not familiar with the rules and the gems and all that kind of stuff, this game works solely off it's almost like a gem mechanic that's very, very clever. And gives you a lot of options, but it also limits you as well. So you're getting a whole handful of these gems on your hero card. They're going to sit at the very, very bottom. So they're going to sit here kind of in the active pool. And when you use the gems, because you only have a certain amount, you're going to be placing them on the different abilities you'd like to do. And then you're going to exhaust them. If you get wounded, they're going to move into a pile you can no longer recover them from. So that's kind of the premise of the game. So you're constantly managing these crystals. It's pretty cool. And I think the designers did a good job of balancing the game out that way. So you got a deck of cards. Here's an example. I'm not going to rip it open because it could take a while. But a decent thickness. And quite a bit of different variations of cards in there. This one's like leather armor, for instance, and lets you roll a yellow dice when you have it. It's just kind of like Zombicide-ish. You got like more like Shadows of Brimstone. You've kind of got like a weight counter of how much you can hold before you start losing abilities on your player board. due to weight limits. Looks like you get a really cool snake in the main box. So of course, it wouldn't be a Conan game without a really, really cool snake mini. And that's exactly what this is. So that's pretty, I'll just give the camera a really good look at that in case you didn't see it. It's very, very cool. And then of course, you get a massive box. Just outright ridiculously huge. Like when I open up Conan or not stuff, it's pretty large. This is humongous. It's like, and these boxes are fairly big in the first place, but this is going to be a tray of just straight minis. So you've got yourself all kinds of different options here. Again, your hero characters are up top. So you got guys like, again, I don't know the names 100%, but I obviously know he's Conan. So he's the coolest hero of them all. And you've got the five different heroes that you can be. And then, of course, everything else is more on a darker gray scale for the enemies. So you've got like what looks to be pirates. You got some kind of winged creatures over here. You've got yourself some wolves or some type of beast, some crazy golem-like creatures, all kinds of stuff. It's just wild. And this is just the first tray level of that box I just opened, so that's quite a bit of stuff. You obviously get some player bases so you can distinguish between the different groups that you're controlling as the Overlord. You get yourself a gigantic, what's kind of looks like a DJ board almost, where you're essentially just putting these, so the tiles that are in this box down here, you punch all these out, they're punch boards, and they represent each miniature in the game, their abilities and their stats and their dice and everything. You're gonna go ahead and put one all the way down to eight in these different little circle holes. You put all of the enemies that apply to a scenario hero here, sorry. Your gems for the Overlord are moving between these two spaces. This is the pool where you have them, this is the pool where you spent them. And you've got some extra abilities that the Overlord can do. They're specific probably to the scenario. And as you go ahead, and if this was, for instance, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and you were to go ahead and spend 4 gems to activate a unit that was here, which is one of these cardboard pieces, then you would activate the unit by moving the gems over to this board. This particular card that represents the one you just paid for would then be picked up, taken, put at the very bottom, and the rest would be shuffled down. So what happens is it stops the Overlord from being able to reactivate the same unit or group of units multiple times in a row without paying a certain amount of gems. So there's a lot of management involved in that. So kind of got to be wary of what you're doing and make sure that you're not overexerting yourself as the Overlord and spreading yourself too thin and or spending your gems too quickly. You got yourself a whole bunch of, kind of hard to tell what these guys are. I guess these guys are considered the Met Warriors, I guess. So some warrior guys in there. Like, the miniatures are really, really cool. Hopefully you guys can kind of see the detail on them. Try to bring it up really close. So, like, that one's pretty cool. And like, those guys are pretty awesome. Like, very, very, very good detail. So if you're worried about, like, buying this game because it's like, well, I'm not really sure if, like, these guys are the company that would have all that great miniatures, you know, this might not be the wisest choice. Like, maybe would rather purchase somebody else's game that probably has better miniatures. Rest assured that these guys have done their homework and they do a good job of the miniatures. They actually have another Kickstarter that they're in the middle of doing for Mythic Battles, I believe, and that ended recently, and the late backers when that ended, and they're going down the same train of thought as this. A little bit different situation from a battling game, but you actually do have a ton of miniatures in that game, and they do a really good job of making them. So we're going to go ahead and move these trays out because we already looked at these. We're going to go ahead and look at these massive pile of punch boards. So again, like I already said, artwork is very cool. Really, you just punch all these out so you have a reference for every single enemy in the game. Obviously got your standard tokens. Here's your 1 to 8 on the Overlord's track, like I was talking about. You got some treasure chests, things like that represent different things. And then these are just scenario specific tokens as per usual. Got some gates and stuff to put up. Very, very cool. Now, the other thing that's really, really cool about this game is the boards, and the artist work on the boards is incredible. Like, I've seen, so what you get in the base game, just to kind of digress on my excitement, essentially, if you have the retail game, you get a board that is this large, and it just is really, really cool. So this is like one example of one of the boards in the game. So it's a massive, massive kind of like fort So you got yourself like a broken area here where, and it's kind of hard to see because there's a lot of glare on that particular spot. So there's a hole, there's like a hole in the side of the castle. So in terms of strategic movement, the areas are not kind of like Zombicide where everything's just a square. There's actually some really abstract shapes and they're all cut in. So when you move from pocket to pocket almost. And it allows for a lot of weird and strategic movement, I guess. You have to actually look to see how often. You can't just look at it and be like, oh yeah, that's gonna be one or two movement. You actually have to sit there and think like, okay, no, that space is this big. This space is only this big. This space is this big. There's a wall there. So there's a lot to like take in as you try to move around the board. But it's really cool art. Looks really, really good. I'm gonna actually go ahead for this part and maybe just knock the night lights down a little bit to hope that the glare kind of comes down a bit. Don't know if that helps or not. Maybe it didn't. But either way, there's a couple lights in here that cause a little bit of glare on the camera. But regardless, you got yourself a really nice castle. So I'll kind of tip it up so you guys can see it. It's very, very cool. Very, very nice. Something that when people see hit the table, they're a little bit blown away. Like, check this out. Like, two ships side by side. Massive battle that kind of occurs over these two ships. You got artwork up here. Like, look at this. You got a shark up in the corner. Down here in the bottom, you kind of got like a whale. You got your anchor flying off the side of the boat. Looks like there's something over here. I can't tell. Looks like could be another shark, I think. Just crazy stuff. And the detail on the actual ships themselves is just insane. I don't know the rules in particular in terms of movement and moving between ships, but I think you can actually swing across the ships and stuff. And if you don't make it, you end up in the water. It's just craziness, but it's really cool. Like, when that hits the table, and you guys can see it in the video here, like, it really makes it pops. Like, these images have a really good, the artist did a really good job of giving this 3D effect, even though it's completely flat. Like, these posts, for instance, kind of give you that feeling like there's actually some depth to the board. So again, I'm going to try to move as quick as possible, but every time I open these up, I kind of get a little too excited about how cool they look. So you don't just get two. You might be sitting there going, well, if I paid for that, you know, paid for that particular, paid for this game and you only get two maps, that's no good. Well, you don't just get two. It wouldn't be Conan without having some kind of in the jungle hut type experience. So making a mess over here. So this one is exactly that. So you've got yourself a massive kind of tribal map. You know, and again, with the whole like look of the 3D kind of popping situation, you've got like a giant like crow flying up here in the sky. So it kind of looks like they're here. You really feel like you're actually above this map. You got like down here to a canyon, you can see a boat down here, some serious depth. You got yourself different huts all around, a different strategy, right? So again, these scenarios, there's not just one scenario per map. So you might think, oh, okay, so there's two double-sided maps. Even though you guys haven't seen the other side of this one, there's multiple scenarios per map. So don't be worried about that. Don't think, oh, there's only four scenarios you're gonna play. No, it's there's more than that. Then on the other side of this, you've got what looks to be kind of like an inn setup. It looks like you're inside of a tavern. So you kind of got like a bar set up over here, and you go up the stairs here, up the stairs here, up the stairs here, and you can head up around this corner here and head down the hallway. Bunch of rooms all the way around, and you can battle it out on this board here. Very, very cool. So again, I don't know the gameplay mechanics, so I can't really give you a heads up on it as to what I'm actually looking at, besides the fact it's obvious that there's some circles on these boards that determine line of sight. They're sectioned off to determine movement, and the scenarios actually specify the majority of the rules regarding kind of what you're actually going to be doing. And I'm sure if you pick it up, you'll dive into that. And if we do a component overview, maybe I can kind of touch into that a little bit. So that's pretty much it. So that essentially is Conan, the unboxing for the retail version. So just to give you guys a quick heads up, this is technically near the end of the video for this one. Now this just covers the, like I said, the retail box. I'm going to link a video which is going to jump into the Kickstarter contents, which you may or may not be able to find online or through BoardGameGeek or eBay or Kijiji or some other means. But just to let you guys know, from what I've heard with this game, don't be afraid that this is not one of those games where if you miss the Kickstarter, that you're missing out on crucial pieces needed to play the game. You're not missing out on crazy game content. The one thing you probably would be missing out on the most, in my opinion, without you guys having seen it yet, but you will if you go to the next video, is you get some extra player boards. So you get some extra maps that you can kind of sprawl out. And having extra maps adds to extra scenarios. And extra scenarios means if the community builds more scenarios on their own, well, you have those options at your fingertips. So there is a little bit of a bonus to having the Kickstarter exclusives, but don't let that shy you away from picking this up, because there's a ton of content in this game. And honestly, I've looked at some reviews online already, and a lot of people are giving it great ratings, and they think that it's an ingenious system with the Overlord versus the many heroes. So, and it's a very, very clever gem mechanic involved in managing your heroes and managing the Overlord. So something you don't want to miss out on, and don't just jump past it or say, ooh, you know, I'm missing this whole extra box, it's not going to be the same experience. Don't do that. Don't miss out on it. I think your friends will like it, because it's, in my opinion, without playing it and seeing some gameplay videos though online, it has, and I hate comparing games side by side, because this is not really comparable to Zombicide, but I'm going to say that it's like, it's in that realm where it's got depth, but it's entry-level depth. So it's entry-level in that it's a miniatures game with dice rolling as its base mechanic. However, where it varies from Zombicide and becomes more complex and more strategic as a miniatures battling game is the one versus many and the gem management aspect, where Zombicide is strictly just moving, you know, doing the best movement you can to the best space available and rolling the dice and hoping you don't screw up. Nothing against Zombicide at all, because I have a whole bunch here in the bottom corner of the screen over here. But at the same time, just so you guys know, like, that is kind of, this is what I think of in terms of if you're going to get somebody into a miniatures game, Zombicide used to be a really, and still is a really good entry-level thing. I think Conan actually could be even better, because it not only gives you that miniature dice rolling, dice chucking kind of adventure, but you also get that one versus many, and you also get that gem management, which gets you way more strategic decisions and way more decisions in your control, which is better. Because when things are in your control, then, you know, the game is more fun, in my opinion. So that's pretty much the whole thing. That is Conan. Sorry for looking at the table for the last minute or so. I'm going to go ahead and put these away. This is the end of the unboxing for this particular game. You'll see the next video pop up on the screen right now in the bottom left. And if you want to subscribe to the channel in the top left, that would be awesome. And I'd love to see you guys kind of come along for the journey as we continue to grow the channel. And we also kind of learn about games as we go along. I hope this is helping you guys out in your purchases. And until next time, keep rolling solo.